first?
I might have. I have no recollection of that, but I might have. So for me, this has been the world. What you're seeing in the trailer has been part of my life for 20 years. So this is a world I know very well. It comes very organic for me. So I do this every Saturday, even till today. So for me, it was just organic, and it just all came together. The stories came from there. I have friends in the nightclub business. I've known a lot of people from this world. So it all just came together well.
Thank you so much. How was it for you to enter the whole web series thing? We all know that you've been a part of such amazing films. You've given us all such amazing blockbusters. But to enter the web series zone, how was it? And why do you think is it viable?
Entering web space for any other format we make or to tell a story is not actually cool. It's a progression of cinema. And when he came with Barker idea, I think it was a great story to tell. So it was a little different than what we normally make in films. A little experimental, a little upbeat, little something which people are not ready to watch. So we chose, like, let's make it. And obviously, great writing, and finally, the audience changing themselves to watch web shows. People at their own convenience can sit and watch something they like. So it was called that we took, and we got made this show, Roy.
That, you know, I love this whole this change that has come into our society. I remember every time I came back home, I would see my mother hooked onto the television waiting for another episode. But now she is actually the person who waits for all of these web series, and she's the one who enjoys it way more than I do, on her own convenience, playing it as and when she wants. So I am totally in love with this change. What do you think about the change that web series have brought and the kind of excitement that audiences have been showing for web series?
So the first and foremost is the medium itself. I think the medium lends to all of this. Television is a one-to-many. There's content that's being made for a certain set of audiences, and that tends to be of a specific type of content being made available. I believe with the digital space, the big change is that it's a one-to-one. I mean, today as a consumer, I pick and choose the genre and the kind of content I want to consume. And I think that is one of the biggest liberation that's happened, where today there's content that's being made for various sets of consumers and communities and various genres of content. And in that, that's also the reason why for Hangama, it's not about only doing drama, only doing crime, only doing comedy. It's about great stories and great narratives. And here, I believe what we're putting out through barcode to the user, we sincerely, as a team, have put in that effort to go out and put together a product that we genuinely believe there will be a set of consumers that will want to come and consume this for the storytelling and the narrative that's being put out to them.
Actually, there's something that I have noticed with all the Hangama originals that I've seen on Hangama Play, be it Damaged, be it Hankar, be it Barcode now. Everywhere you can see that gray shade of human nature, and that is something that I personally have, and that's why I would like to see in everything that I see. So that is something that is constant with all the Hangama originals. So guys, without wasting any more time, do we want to call the star cast? So let's call the star cast on stage. People who need no introduction: Karan Vahi, Akshay Oberoi, Pareena Chopra, and Simran Kaur Mundi. Can we have a huge round of applause for all four of them? The Fantastic Four. All right, so Karan, starting off with you. You know, I need to tell you something. They say that, your first impression of a person is actually your last impression. And I remember him from the remix days. And he was this really good boy over there amidst all the bad people. And then you see him doing all these roles of gray shade. And every time I see a trailer where Karan Vahi does a role of gray shade, I tell myself, "Achha ladka bigad gaya bichara." I still have that good boy image. What is, does this happen to you very often?
I was told women dig bad boys. So I just became one. I'm just glad I'm not the anchor tonight. But
Yeah, we see him doing that even more often.
I was actually, wondering, I was like, do they have an anchor or should I only go today? But yeah, it's fun. Like, you know, I think it's always fun to work on different things that you keep, you know, evaluating yourself. For the longest time, I wanted to do something negative or gray. And everyone used to tell me that, "Arey, tu itna cute sa bachcha hai.
Exactly.
Tu tujh pe suit nahin karega." And unfortunately, what happens is a lot of times the way you look, especially in our country, people perceive you for characters in that only that way only. So I'm glad that people are actually seeing the bad boy in me. Gives me more opportunities and gives me you know, more variations in the kind of work I do.
I mean, seriously, look at him over there. Look at the forehead, the
frown. Do I look like a bad boy there?
You do look like a very,
I think
very
I
bad
look
boy
sexy.
Parina. So, firstly, how was your experience working with the man behind you, Vignesh? 20 years in a nightclub, he knew every single thing the way it's supposed to. How finicky was he with everything?
Say good things, he'll edit you.
Guys,
it's still not on.
Like, my co-actors know, like, what we're going to say about our director. Like, you all have discussed for so long that we've been talking about, you know, how good he is with his own product. For him, it's a baby, right? Barcode is something very close to him. And he cannot at any point do anything wrong, be it any character, be it Karan, Simran, Akshay, mine, anybody, or be it other characters also. He's worked so hard with me, and whereas there was a lot of workshops taken before this series was started, and I know, like, one sentence also I'll say, and sir would be like, "No, Parina, we can do this in a better way." And I'm like, "Yes, we can." And I'm a new artist. So, and he's worked really hard with me, especially for him and I, especially in the show, it's the first thing. For me, coming here and doing this also feels very special. And I'm very happy to be part of Barcode.
And I'm sure it's going to, you know, your entire tenure and every single thing is going to go a very, very long way, because it is Barcode. It's something that is so exciting and something that already looks so amazing. Yes. Akshay, you have had a legacy of such amazing films and then web series, and there are so many projects that are coming up as far as, you know, your career is concerned. In this entire pool of projects and everything, web series, what does that give to you? What is that for you?
Well, I think this web space is a very exciting space for everyone, because a lot of young actors and directors, writers are getting a platform that they perhaps would not have gotten before. I think a talent like Vignesh Shetty getting to do a web series is, I'm sure Vignesh will be making several feature films for you guys to all see soon. Maybe Abhishek Pathak will be part of them. Because he's a very talented guy, but to get a leg up, to get that platform, you know, to
he's
see
like,
his work,
obvious.
To see his work shine, this web series space is a great space. And as far as, you know, what it means to me is that it gives you it's a way to explore, because a lot of what I like to do, I'm not really ever chasing stardom, to be really honest with you. That's not something I ever set out to do. I always wanted to be the best possible actor I could be. And sometimes in films, you get kind of pigeonholed into certain characters and certain playing something a certain way. And directors also want it in a certain way. In the web space, there is much more creative freedom. So there's room to experiment. There are room to try things. Language is not a concern. Nobody comes to you and says, "Are yaar, Hindi mein bolo, ya Angrezi mein bolo." It's much more open. And you can do many things that perhaps somebody would be like, "Nahi yaar, hamari audience isko pasand nahi karegi." You know, like, "What if I played it this way? Nahi, ye zyada subtle ho gaya, logon ko samajh mein nahi aayega." So those restrictions are no longer there in this space. And I think that the future of Bollywood or our Hindi film industry or Hindi industry in general looks a lot more promising to me when you have young talents like Vignesh Shetty and other people who are making web series coming out and doing it by the numbers. Because now it'll be merit. It'll be the people who are actually good at their job and know their craft that get that next bump up.
Right. Simran, how was it working with the three present over here? How was it? What was the on-set chemistry with all of them like?
So Vahi, I knew from before, and Akshay and Parina, however, I've met on set, and I think we all share a very good working relationship. And during this process of working together, we've also formed a very good bond of friendship. And I wanted to add one thing, especially for Vahi, because Akshay, we've seen him act before in several films, and we know, you know, like the kind of roles that he does. But Vahi, however, like you mentioned, is in this very cute chocolate boy image and breaking that barrier and actually being able to do this role and play Vicky to its and give complete justice. I think hats off to him. He's done a brilliant job at it, and it's I think a give and take. Like for me, you know, especially. So I had most of my scenes, not coming to Akshay, most of my scenes were with Akshay. And I believe as an actor, he gave me enough for me to respond to him. Because if you have a good actor that you work with, and if that comfort and that thing is there, and somewhere I do believe that my performance in this has really improved because of Akshay and the way he gave me the dialogues and the way I reacted to them. So it's been a great experience overall, and the most special mention I want to give is to our director Vignesh Shetty. I cannot. He's the toughest taskmaster. He's just brilliant. I mean, it was amazing working with him. And if you work with him once, you will know exactly what we've gone through, and I do wish you work with all of you.
I think I'm just going to interrupt for 1 second. The trailer you guys just watched, there's a slight, small voiceover of mine in the start of it, which maybe, 40 seconds? And I did 44 takes of that in the dubbing studio until the man was in, like, I would be like, "Are ho gaya yaar, phaad diya maine," and I'd walk out of the dubbing studio, and look at me and say, actually, I feel that one word. No, can we do it one more time? So I was like, okay. And with him, you can't argue. And I don't want to get into a space where I'm arguing with him because he knows what he wants and he's right. So I would go back in. And when I left, I checked, how many takes did I do? It's 44 takes. Either that means I'm awful or it means like he's insane.
He is too good.
He's crazy.
I think we should definitely not go by face value because just look at him. Bhola bhala chehra. 44 takes. All of them are lying, right? I should go by the face value.
Are you
sure?
That's
what we all did.
We
went by
today.
Face value.
No, we should ask him. Are you sure you want to release it today? Or there's
you
want
to wait? You want to pull it off the platform? You want to do degrading again?
No, no. We are all set no matter what you guys say. अच्छा यूजुअली जब कोई फिल्म की शूटिंग होती है जब कोई वेब सीरीज की शूटिंग होती है इट्स ईदर ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स ऑफ मुंबई यू आर गोइंग टू द स्लम्स और यू आर गोइंग ऑन द यू नो ऑन द रोड टॉकिंग टू पीपल ओवर हियर द सीन इज कंप्लीटली इट्स सोबो फर्स्टली इट्स सोबो एंड यू आर इन द नाइट क्लब्स सो हाउ लाइक डिड यू गाइस एवर ट्राई टू कैलकुलेट द आवर्स स्पेंट इन अ नाइट क्लब जस्ट फॉर दिस वेब सीरीज लाइक हाउ ऑफन डिड यू गाइस एक्चुअली गो टू नाइट क्लब्स एंड वाज योर वर्कशॉप इन द नाइट क्लब
नो It was in the Panorama.
I think a couple of us grew up in a generation when nightclubs were very popular. And I mean, I'm speaking for some people here. When I'm mostly Wahi because I feel like we have a similar sort of, I mean, he was in Delhi, I was in Bombay. But I think that people of this generation have seen a lot of nightclubs. I don't think that was a necessary part of it because we have seen it already. So that's just what I feel. I don't know if you guys.
True. So I'm going to open the platform for media Q&A. If anybody has a question, please ask for the mic and go ahead.
Hello. Mera sawal Karan se. Hi, Karan.
Hi.
Rehman from ANI.
Hi, Rehman.
Personally, aapka kya thoughts hai digital ko leke aur kitna grow kar raha hai aur हमने सुना कि आगे भी आपकी वेब सीरीज हैं हंगामा के साथ उसके बारे में थोड़ा जानना चाहिए
क्या बात कर रहे हो यार
यू
डिडंट टेल मी नहीं बट थैंक यू रहमान वेल यार मैं प्राइमरीली एक टीवी बैकग्राउंड से आता हूँ मैंने बहुत टेलीविजन किया है लाइफ में और यू नो पहले एक टेलीविजन होता था और फिल्म्स होती थी बीच में कुछ नहीं होता था एंड आई एम सो ग्लैड कि द वेब स्पेस has actually given so many actors, if I'm speaking for myself, main agar apne liye bolun to, the potential and the chance to do so much more. Itna kuch, hum jab TV mein hote hain, I'm not gonna demerit it, but hum hamesha television actors ke muh se sunte hain ki yaar, content itna kamal nahi hai, hum kaam karte hain karne ke liye. To जब वेब स्पेस बड़ा हो रहा था या यू नो वी स्टार्टेड आई थिंक ऑलमोस्ट अ ईयर एंड अ हाफ बैक एक डेढ़ साल पहले हमने बाकोड शुरू किया था तब वेब इतना ज़्यादा इंडिया में पॉपुलर हुआ नहीं था मासी. तो आई थिंक एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिलता है अच्छा काम करने का, एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिलता है. जैसे अक्षय ने कहा कि कोई इश्यूज़ नहीं होते लैंग्वेज के, कि आपको हिंदी में ही बात करनी है या इंग्लिश में ही बात करनी है, या एक तरीका होता है जिससे हम बात करते हैं. वो फ्रीडम मिलता है. आई थिंक फॉर एन एक्टर दैट्स द बेस्ट थिंग दैट यू कैन गेट, बिकॉज यू आर जस्ट गोना बी अ कंप्लीट एक्टर इफ़ यू ट्राई एंड डू थिंग्स यू नो विच आर डिफरेंट, एंड इफ़ यू ट्राई टू इवॉल्व विद द थिंग्स दैट आर हैपनिंग. तो आई थिंक मुझे आई एम रियली रियली ग्लैड एंड आई एम ग्रेटफुल कि मुझे ये प्लेटफॉर्म मिला है. और आई होप आपकी बात सच हो जाए. हंगामा सुन रहे हो तो प्लीज़ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट भेज देना. एंड आई होप आई कीप डूइंग गुड स्टफ एंड आई कीप एंटरटेनिंग पीपल.
जैसे भी आपने कहा कि कंटेंट ही किंग है वेब सीरीज को लेकर, कहीं ना कहीं ये आपको लगता है कि वेब सीरीज में अनसेंसर कंटेंट होते हैं, सेंसर नहीं होता है, लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं न्यूडिटी दिखाने से व्यूअर्स और फैंस को भी डिसअपॉइंटेड होता है?
सर वो डिपेंड करता है, मतलब डिपेंड्स ऑन शो टू शो. मैं अगर पर्सनली, ये मेरा पर्सनल थॉट प्रोसेस है कि न्यूडिटी जहाँ ज़रूरी है वहाँ ज़रूरी है. बिकॉज अगर मैं अपने आप को एक एक्टर बोलता हूँ तो मैं कुछ भी करने के लिए तैयार होना चाहिए इफ़ आई बिलीव इन द थॉट प्रोसेस. अगर मैं बिलीव करता हूँ कि मैं स्मोक कर सकता हूँ ऑन कैमरा क्योंकि मेरे कैरेक्टर को स्मोकिंग दिखानी है या करनी चाहिए, तो आई थिंक when that nudity clause specially comes in India, we overthink it. But person to person hai. Mera personally manna ye hai ki till the time it's not just for the heck of it, it's good. Yes, there are a lot of content out there jo primarily focus us pe karte hain. But wo unka, you know, thought process hai. Us pe main na to rok tok kar sakta hun, na main kuch comment karna chahunga.
अब अपने फ्रेंड ऋत्विक की वेब सीरीज ट्रिपल एक्स अल्ट बालाजी की, वो देखी आपने?
मैंने यार बालाजी की ट्रिपल एक्स देखी नहीं है, बट वो अगर एक शो का नाम ही ट्रिपल एक्स है, सो आई थिंक यू ऑलरेडी नो व्हाट दे आर ट्राइंग टू सेल. अब मैं जब वो शो देखूंगा तो मैं कमेंट कर पाऊंगा कि वो कितना जायज़ है और कितना नहीं है.